The following program is brought to you in living color.
Good morning.
Good morning.
That was like that was a personal crooning moment there.
Yeah, my bad was late. That's Roy's fault, not Jimmy. Sorry, everyone who was waiting. Yep, that was me. Sorry. I apologize. Anyway, 5 after 9th
of February.
I'm Roy Brister of the Roy and Jimmy thing. Roy and Jimmy in the morning. Oops. This is
this that dude. Guy.
This dude.
I am Jimmy Shaw. Good morning, everybody. Roy and Jimmy in the morning right here. YouTube Live, Facebook Live, and everybody in the house there. Good morning. Art from Texas. There's my sister, Drew Yerkish, the birthday girl, Lisa Sloan. Happy birthday. Everybody wish Lisa Sloan a happy birthday. And there's my mom. Hello, mother.
Hey, don't say it like that. That sounds weird.
Hello, mother.
Mother. Either like call her. Have some fava beans.
Either call her mom, mother, or sometimes I just call her woman. Hey, woman.
Yeah.
You know, got to keep this shit real.
You don't ever call her, hey, mama, baby.
No, I do not call her mama, baby. It's our Tuesday. Man. Oh, there's your mother. Look at all the mothers are in the room.
Hi.
Birth or
There's
otherwise.
A bunch of mothers in here.
I'm telling you.
That includes Drew. Oh, different but, kind of mother.
But there's Drew with the happy birthday to Lisa right off the bat there.
Okay. Hey, Drew.
We'll call him redeemed.
Drew, I'm going to give you one right now. Good job, brother. He knows what I'm talking about.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's a little inside Drewish.
That's kind of scary.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good job, Drew.
Yeah. Lisa, the happiest of birthdays to you on a day that we celebrate the day that you were brought into this world so you could touch all of our lives.
We almost had to take a day off and make it a Roy and Jimmy holiday.
That's about as like heartfelt as I'm going to ever get on this show.
Ever get?
No, not in life, because I get that a lot.
Right.
But I mean, on the show, for some reason, I pull over the dickish guy, and I don't want to be that guy to Lisa, because Lisa's the coolest of coolest shits of all cool. So cool.
So
I mean, we're talking 80s Camaro cool.
Wait, let me get this straight. Other times you're making her do the patented head slap.
Yeah.
Face slap, head slap. But today.
Today.
The angelic tones.
Yes.
Of Roy Brister.
Yes.
Because of the birthday.
And I'm going to tell you, Lisa, that video you posted this morning probably was the reason I was late this morning.
Oh, the chocolate?
Motorcycle chocolate
thing. That was pretty cool.
I couldn't stop watching it. And next thing you knew, I was late.
It was that good.
I didn't know it was so long. I've never heard that before. I didn't know it was so long. But it's, yeah. I think that messed into my morning time. But here, normally, I would get on Lisa's business,
right?
About saying it's your problem, it's your fault. I was late, but today I'm saying thank you for sharing that. It lightened my day. It brought me in a good mood, even though I was a few minutes late. It just made me appreciate you all that much more because shared something so fantastic with the world, just like you share yourself with the world. And Lisa, you know, I'm going to tell you right now, we love you.
Oh, dear God. Oh, dear God, what have you done to our Roy?
No, this is the way it is. This is Roy off the radio.
Lisa, please, I need you.
Off the radio, Roy, all day today.
I need you to do that one. There it is.
And Lisa, we all know Lisa's beautiful. But the most beautiful part of Lisa is her heart.
Oh my God. I'm not going to say no.
Right. What are you going to do with that?
I just feel like a shovel full of everything going on.
That's not a shovel. This is Roy.
There's Roy. Art's got it. Make sure you thank your mom and Lisa when you accept your Academy Award.
if you peel the layers
good Lord.
Of Lisa's outer beauty, you find the seed of what beauty really is.
I think you find Steve Perry.
Yeah, you might do that.
It might be a little Steve Perry. He's got that glow of that Perry glow.
You know what happens if you peel that up and then it comes out? All of a sudden, you know how that song starts right at the very beginning where it's really quiet? And then you hear, "You should have been lost." That part comes out.
Oh, I see. The crescendo coming up. Yeah. I gotcha.
It's like, oh. When you peel the onion that is Lisa.
The onion, yes. Peel the onion.
Get to the core that is beauty.
Yes.
I don't want anything except the gift of your friendship. What?
I was letting you finish.
That was it. Well, that was it for that moment.
Okay. I got you. Okay.
Are you having to work today on your birthday, Lisa?
I don't think they are.
You know what cracks me up sometimes is, you know, you realize like when you're younger, you're like, maybe you're working in your teens or 20s or something like that. Probably it goes to then. And you work on your birthday. It's, I got to work on my birthday.
Right.
And then you get to like 35-ish and you're like, so?
I'll take that money.
No work on your birthday. You know what? That is good because I would have messaged you for a phone number of the person that I need to converse with to make sure that you were off today with pay.
Oh, I see.
And I could have made that happen.
Well, I know.
You've heard. Talent.
Oh, I know we saved this for the birthday game. We'll do it later, but just in honor of her.
Yo, are you standing on a corner, Lisa, right now? I just need to know.
Are you taking it easy?
Yeah. Yeah, I bet she is right now. She has got to be standing. No, it's kind of early. She's probably not standing on a corner yet. You know. Well, you know what? In saying Lisa standing on a corner brings a bad connotation to what she might be. And I don't want that happening. Sort of. Leaning on a corner? I mean.
Since she was in the, her and Ron are in the Howard Hughes room.
Yeah, I saw that. That was actually pretty cool.
Told her to tap them. Surprise. Tap them walls.
And you know what else? You know what else that makes me know? Because she said, thank you for the. That means Ron. I'm thinking, I could be wrong. It's a little surprise Ron worked out for, which means Ron was attracted to everything that Lisa is. And was put in her life to make sure that she is happy and lives the best life she can live. She's living her best life right now.
Okay.
Even though she's not standing on a corner. She's kind of, sort of. I don't know what that means. One leg, laying down, sitting. I don't know. Oh, matter of fact, I'll be on the corner later. Okay. All right. There we go.
Got to pay for dinner.
There we go. Look at that good looking man right there. She just snagged. I saw the picture when you put it up. That's what I was looking at.
Oh, I see. I see.
You're like, what are you looking at, Roy?
I'm trying to see what you're looking at there.
So I think that is probably 4 minutes of Lisa talk for this morning.
And
there may be more later.
Why are you so nice to me?
You know what? Honestly, if we're not on the radio show, Lisa, you can let it be known. I am never not nice to you. Off air. See? It's just a little fun we have.
I see. Well, in honor of your birthday, pick anything off the shelf. Right here.
All right, let me see.
It's like a carnival game.
You know what I'm going to do? This is what I'm going to do.
Anything off the shelf.
Let me see if I can find something here we're going to share with Lisa.
And we can ship it to you. In fact, what I got here, I got a beautiful salt shaker.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh.
Matching,
here we go.
Matching pepper.
Here we go.
Matching pepper.
How about
right
this?
Right there.
How about this?
Matching pepper.
Oh, upside down. How about a nice pen with a stylus?
Oh, boy. Dreams come true.
Yeah, yeah.
Birthday dreams do come true.
Yeah, that'll work. Love you too, Lisa. So how about this?
How about an official?
Oh, I got one of these too. Look at this.
How about an official Rory and Jimmy?
Paperclip?
Mug.
One of these. Oh, that might be fun. Duck. One of those.
Oh, we'll see. There's so many lovely prizes. What else have I got?
I have so many things here on the counter.
I
might share with you.
Got a napkin holder.
Oh.
Napkin holder. Old napkins. And it's decorative. We can ship that off.
Yeah. I could send a business card too.
Good thing I'm in the house today because I got the nice
stuff. You don't want to give away any of the shit in the garage because that stuff's good stuff.
Like an oil can or...
No, because she'd be wanting like something cool off the wall.
One of my multiple half-inch wrenches.
Yeah, but you don't have a 10 millimeter, do you?
I do. Huh. I even got the ones that are the ratchet ones too. Yeah, I was living large back in the day. All the wrenches, baby. So what do you want? I want everything. All these.
I want
all these.
I want all of them, son.
Before we get too far into it, a big shout out to Greg Dixon yesterday. Having him on the show, we had a great time with him. Definitely check him out. Wednesdays, 5 p.m., 6 p.m., LATalkRadio.com.
Mm. You know, Greg was a good time yesterday.
All right. Quick, get away my stuff. Babe, it's just what I could reach. I'll get you another one. Oh, yeah, there she goes. She said, Lisa's forever grateful for her iPad.
You know what I want to know is if you updated it yet. Is it still running? Is it working all right?
Just sees out of, only see out of the left side.
Yeah.
The left side of it.
Yeah.
Guess what right. Guess what I got to do. Anyways, happy birthday, Lisa. Enjoy your happy day, birthday. You and Ron.
Enjoy your special day.
I got to do something really neat yesterday, last night, that I haven't done in a long time. For a very long time. I took a bath.
Oh, I saw that.
Yes, yes. So the as everyone knows from yesterday, the water heater is done. Guy came out and looked at it and went, oof. It's done. And so we have a new one coming in today. So that put us in a little conundrum. Now, Ariana needed to go on a road trip yesterday. Obviously, she couldn't because we had no hot water. But now...
Why you can't go on a road trip with no hot water? Your car runs on hot water?
Personal appearance, cleanliness.
I saw the stove all filled up with hot water.
Yeah, absolutely. Went old school with that. So fired up four pots. Got the tea kettle going. I washed her hair in the kitchen sink with that, and then bathtub, buckets of water. And it looked so refreshing. I jumped in there, and it's exactly like I tell everybody. As soon as I got in the tub, she started laughing. My feet in my private parts were wet. Everything else was dry docked. So a lot of splish splashing, but you know what? You got to be a 5-year-old once in a while.
Yeah, gotta do it.
Just rub dub dub, turn on the radio, just start a playing and making. And I wish I just had some like a rubber ducky or something. So it's a clean and sheen today. Old school though, pots of water, boom.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that cold shower Sunday. Oh dear Lord, dear God, no.
Yeah, that can, that'll wake you up.
I mean, you can do it in the river, but you're drunk. And once you take that first splash, it's like a pool or anything else, you're over it. Just got to go full on body in. Well, yeah. At home, you can't do that. It's the little hand. What you got there?
Nothing.
Oh, little hand, little toe tap. And you just get more chicken the more you feel that. So a warm bath.
Yeah, it's see, here's the thing that makes me wonder about that, because if you go to the beach, you go jump in the water, it might be 50 something degrees.
Right.
Okay.
But you go in.
Now, did you go in? But the shower spraying is probably, might even be a little warmer than that if you really checked it. but you just can't get yourself in it. And then if you do, here's the thing. So you're washing and then you haven't got your back yet. And then you want to wash your hair or but you're afraid to, cause you know, it's going to run down your back and make you do the thing. Right?
Yes. All senses are heightened. Yeah. It was brutal. I couldn't do it. But hot water, boiled bath water.
Well,
and it worked. It was fine. It was fine. It was nice to get checking in all the crevasses, get everything all nice and taken care of.
Yeah. Well, the only thing about, because sometimes I'll, Don laughs at me because if I'm really cold,
mm-hmm.
and we've got a big jacuzzi tub. And if I'm cold and can't get warm, I'm like, man, I'm going to take a shower. I don't. I go up and fill up the bathtub with hot water.
Oh, wow.
And I get like thawed out. And then I rinse off and then I jump in the shower.
Right.
You know, because I like to rinse off the funk of Roy that I may have.
The funk of Roy, yes.
Yeah, the funk of Roy. I think they're going to make a play out of that. It was kind of like the Book of Mormon.
Yeah, the funk of Roy. Roy.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's going to happen. Stay tuned. But
stay tuned.
Yeah, there's something about that I, you know, it's like it feels good and everything. And you might even have some, you know, you might have a bath bomb in there. I'm not afraid of doing that.
Right.
Or maybe some Epsom salts or something smells good. Maybe I want to be nice to myself, light a couple candles.
Sure.
You know, I may or may not adjust one of the jets in a special place. I ain't going to share. But when I'm done, I need to go in the shower.
Just gotcha.
Just rinse off.
Just rinse off just a little bit.
It sounds kind of stupid, right?
No. There's nothing wrong with that, Roy.
It's kind of weird.
Nothing wrong with
that. But a lot of people, when they get out of the shower, I mean, you know, you see a woman in a sexy bath scene and she gets done and she lotions up and wipes up. She doesn't go to get in the shower and rinse off and come out, and it kills the mood. She gets out of the shower and wipes a towel on her leg and gets all ready and then wraps it around how the women do that little thing right here and put it in the head turban.
Sure. Tell us more.
Maybe I'll just do that next time.
I'll
do that next time. Just kind of walk up and I'll yell down the stairs. Hey, babe. Fresh out of the tub.
It's time. When I say it's time.
And lotioned up. I just turned myself on.
I was going to say, you need a minute?
Yeah.
It's getting hot. I was thinking about hot in here.
It's like crazy.
It's getting hot in here.
So I know we did a little bit of Super Bowl talk yesterday, but I shared something with you yesterday that I think you saw that I want to share with everybody today because I'm going to share
it. Do it.
I don't know did anyone see the guy jump on the field thing?
You showed a quick pic of it yesterday.
But no, that was after.
Oh yeah, when he got tackled.
By ourselves.
Right. Oh, right. Yeah, bring it.
Yeah. So, I don't know if anyone got to see the guy. But here's the dude. apparently he was wearing a bathing suit thong thing. And you know what? I don't know if I hit sound. Let's see, did I hit it?
Yeah.
Okay. And here he goes. Now, the cool thing I like is when people do this, they don't show them anymore. You know, this is like cell phone cameras from because they're like, we're not going to give them notoriety.
Right. Sure.
For this shit. But here we go. Here he goes. Shoes, booty. Yeah. Peace sign. Uh-oh, here we go. Got some moves.
Good move.
Got
good move.
Oh. At the 20, at the 15, the 10, the 5. Oh,
got him on the 1 yard. Incomplete.
It cracks me up, man. The 10, the 5, the
the 1. The thong is down at the 1.
Whoa, what's going on here? There we go. I had to shut it off.
There's Art. Fling your challenge.
Made me giggle. I gotta share things like that.
Oh, absolutely.
So Art, fling your towel at her. Come on, baby. Bam. More Super Bowl talk. There's one that made me laugh. And this is not Super Bowl, really. This is like, shut the hell up. Did you know that Patrick Mahomes?
Yes.
We knew he was under fire all night running from the defense.
Right.
Next Gen Stats So they do the stats.
Okay.
So Patrick Mahomes ran a total of 497 yards before his passes or got sacked.
Deuce.
500 yards.
Wow. Guy got raped, man. That was horrible.
That was horrible. But there is something that I can't believe I lost.
You lost. What did you lose, Roy?
I lost something because I kind of wanted to say, I was a little taken back by it. Where's that? Yeah, can't find it. Patrick Mahomes' girlfriend.
Yes.
Was in the news.
Okay.
But I got to look at, I got to find the story because I saved it. Patrick Mahomes' girlfriend. Twitter. Oh, that must be, that's probably it. That's what's on the searching. Can't find it, but I don't know what happened. Oh, there it is. There it is. So Patrick Mahomes' fiance Brittany Matthews slams ESPN over Super Bowl tweets.
Okay.
Okay.
Such as
Brittany Matthews got angry and tweeted, "Cool ESPN, love the support of major sports platform for one of its best players in the league." She got mad and blasted him for posting a picture of Patrick dejected after the loss.
Don't we always do that?
Yeah. Saying that it was unfair and she can't believe that they did that to him in a time when that shouldn't happen.
It's sports, man.
Brittany, shut your friggin' pie hole.
It's sports.
Horrible.
Now
not
you
how
know
we wanted to end, but
you know he's more out.
And always and forever I am proud of him. But they got freaking ripped because of, and you know what it makes me want to go? It makes me want to say, Patrick, I want you to go home and tell your fiance.
Fiance.
It's over.
Well, you know, he's more mad at her for that than what ESPN did.
What are you doing?
It's like, what the hell, lady?
Do they get pictures of grown men crying on the freaking, sometimes on the benches at World Series?
Yeah, you sit there, you're dejected, you got your, oh, poor baby.
Poor baby. How about Ben? They said when Pittsburgh lost to Cleveland, Ben was actually crying and they showed him and Pouncey on the sidelines having a moment and they reported it. Yeah, that's what you do. Hey, listen here. You know what? You know what the problem with her is?
What's her problem?
Her problem is her name's Brittany.
Two T's.
It all started from then.
Two T's, i.e.
Oh my God. I just blown away. Like and, said, and here's why Brittany needs to shut her freaking mouth, because she's not going to have a problem with this, right? The team that loses Super Bowl 55. And his players received $65,000. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But they will actually, by the time all the course and postseason is all done, he made an extra $185,000 for losing the Super Bowl.
Oh, the poor baby. No wonder she was crying.
Brittany, you're not going to get any of it because you're bitching. Although Tom Brady made an additional $500,000. Because he had bonuses.
Right.
And this one kind of, the winner's share is 130 grand. So if you go all the way through the playoffs and win, that's a cool $250,000.
Right.
Now, this one's the one that made me mad. Is Antonio Brown, who is a great talent, but a freaking jackhole. A freaking idiot. Can't keep his shit together. Needs to shut his freaking mouth. What a great talent, but a freaking idiot. In my view. So I don't get caught because he's probably listening right now. He made an extra $750,000 by going to the Super Bowl, and he had to play 35% of the snaps. That was in his contract when it came in. So Antonio, $750,000 for that. No big deal. That's just what we do.
Right.
Yeah. For getting in trouble for not having shit going on. $2.25 million for Tom Brady. In his contract is additional if you happen to make it.
Damn.
You know what? You know what? Giselle already has all the money in the family. What's he trying to do? Catcher?
These are the quarterbacks I miss right here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lynn Dawson having a smoke and a fresco at halftime.
Yeah.
Sweaty, dirty, having a smoke going, whew, what a game.
Yeah.
That's some men shit right there.
Right. Oh, don't post that shit.
But now we're all pampered and carried off the field. And oh, don't put that picture of my boyfriend on there. He had a bad day.
Patrick Mahomes, this is what says, fiance Brittany Matthews slams ESPN over Super Bowl tweets. Shut up.
But right there, there's your quarterback right there. This one I'll take all day long.
You know what? Hey, you know what, Lynn Dawson right there, due to Brittany? You know, I don't want to say anything bad about Patrick. He's got some moves. He's good looking. Great shape. Get a night with old Len. Change your world.
Exactly.
Just saying.
I was out and about on Saturday. And, you know, you see things. You see things and you wonder what the hell people are thinking here. This is what I saw. This is, it's a local one. So if this is one of you guys' friends, let them know. But check out that license plate, that personalized license plate. That could be a couple things. Could be that dumbass who runs the punk rock show, Dutchie Senior.
Yeah.
Or I went with Douche. Douche Senior, meaning there's a Douche Junior out there somewhere. And if anyone knows what that actually means, let me know. Because, you know, your first impressions.
Maybe it's past. Maybe it's the Duchy.
Pass the Duchy.
Pass it on the right side.
And right there, Duchy's or Duchess. Because it was in the Upland area, so it could say Duchess, and her first name is Brittany. Yeah, it could be one of those moves. Duchess. I am Duchess.
Yeah.
My daddy says I'm a Duchess.
You know, did you not think that out a little bit?
Right, exactly.
And I mean, I can't believe that the DMV let that happen, because I tried to get the, on my Ram truck, I had to get HEMIROYD, hemiroid. They did not allow that to happen. Or it was HEMIRYD is what it was.
Right.
That's what it was, I think. Anyway.
And they said no.
Well, I actually paid for it and everything. Bless you.
So thank you.
I paid for it, got it done. I'm like, oh my God, it's on the way. It's going to be great.
Right.
And then I got a thing in the mail said, uh-uh.
Really?
Yep. Not allowed. I'm like, dude, it's a Hemi truck, and my name is Roy.
Yeah. Hemi Roy.
Maybe if I just put Hemi R-Y, I could have got away with it.
Yeah, but that's no fun. You had the room. You had the 7 digits.
Yeah, they didn't like it. They gave me my money back.
Well, there you go. That's somewhere in Upland, people. So SUV, Brittany walking around, driving around as a Duchess. So definitely watch your ass.
You know what? That might have been Brittany Mahomes.
It might have been her just cruising Upland going, I've had enough of this town. I'll be in Upland for Super Bowl if you need me.
I think it might have been. Might have been. Hey, you know what I want to say right now?
Yes.
I think we need to bring it up again. Happy birthday to the lovely and beautiful Lisa Sloan.
If you missed it the first time. If she's still hanging with us.
In case you missed the happy birthday we did for a little while ago.
So what, like every half hour?
You know why?
Bring it up.
I just realized she said she's kind of standing on a corner. She's in Winslow.
Winslow, Arizona.
Winslow, Arizona. Yes. And she wasn't standing on the corner yet. But you know what's going on right now? She might be laying down, you know what I'm saying? Big Ron, happy birthday shit right now.
Right. Oh my God. Right. Your wife is listening. Winslow, you know, Don's going to give you some shit now.
Why? I've been nice to Lisa all morning.
You
Why
have
would
been.
I get shit for that?
No, you, you know what? You have Donna been nice.
Missed the morning Lisa beauty thing. You know, all I said was Lisa is so beautiful, but when you peel the outside beauty, the inner core is what lights up the world.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. Kind of like an onion.
Like an onion.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, not like an apple, because you peel an apple like with a knife and then you get to the core. It's kind of shitty. No, that's not Lisa.
No, you're pairing it at that time.
Right. Right. We're not pairing Lisa.
No.
Although Ron might be pairing her.
Shit. Right.
All right. Happy birthday, Lisa. Just love you. Letting a little love, give me a little bit of love.
Where do you go from there?
I made myself laugh. We're going to have Sean. Well, you know what? We might save some of these for Sean. I got a couple good stories. This might be a good one because I think Sean would kind of like run the gamut on this one.
Sure.
I just sometimes you have that thought where you're like, Sean might have a little fun with that. As a matter of fact, Sean might have had some fun with Brittany.
Right.
Ah, damn it.
Well, I think I sent him that.
What?
That picture. The Brittany picture.
Which one? Where she was?
The Duchess. I sent you guys that.
Yeah, no, yeah. Yeah, we saw that one.
You know, if you're looking for February is not only the month of love with Valentine's Day, it's also Roy's birthday this month. And if anyone's thinking of a gift.
Oh, yeah.
Run over to wish.com.
Yep.
Get rid of that muscular onesie right there.
I could pull that.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
Roy show now.
Jesus.
No Roy and Jimmy. It's just Roy.
My
oh, there he is.
My mouse is freaking sensitive. Jesus.
What I was going to do is...
let's get back to that take two. And there you go. The month of love. It's not only Valentine's Day.
So what
it's
I think
Roy's
I would,
birthday.
Yeah, I think what I'd do is I'd move that moon right there, right down around the package.
Well, yeah, Allie's birthday this month too. Oh, look at that. A bunch of Pisces going on.
Yeah, bunch of fish.
Bunch well, of
actually,
fishies.
If it's early in the month, I think it's not a Pisces.
Oh, that's right. It's still Aquarius.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Aquarius.
It's well in the age
Aquarius.
Of
Aquarius.
Not quite. It's also the month Scorpios are made. Oh, I see. We're talking in the 9 months from now.
Huh? 9 months.
You know, 9 months you're pregnant. Yeah, so yeah. If you make a Scorpion now.
Oh,
I see. So 19th is the 19th is the switchover. So are you a Pisces, Allison, or are you an Aquarius? Inquiring minds want to know.
Inquiring minds want to know what the day is.
Say it.
It's also the month Scorpios are made. I like that.
Yeah.
Use a condom. Jesus.
She's the one that said the month scorpions are made and then use a condom.
Right.
How can I make a scorpion if we're wearing a condom? Pisces
maybe
just
that's
like
how
me.
They're made.
Oh, Pisces like me. And Roy, you're a Pisces,
yeah,
right?
We're both fish.
Yes.
You know why?
Because
we're slippery and spinny. What's up, Steve?
Good morning, Steve.
We can slither when needed. We're strong. We chase bait, stuff like that.
Now, Steve here.
Our women hooked us. See?
Uh huh.
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay. Now, Steve here. I've never met him. Seems like a very nice guy, but he's a friend of Donna Maine's, and he pops in here thinking she's on the show.
Yeah, he didn't want to listen.
He doesn't know her like we know him, or she. You know what I mean? He thinks he knows her, but you know she'll be in whenever. Is how we finally accepted all that.
You know, if you listen long enough, you see I don't even want her in here.
So
for some reason she's like the guy in Office Space, just keeps showing up.
The red stapler.
Stapler.
No, we love Donna, but if you came in tune in for Donna, go get some coffee. Go chill. Take a lap. Take a lap. It eventually happens. But we don't set our clock to it.
Well, that's kind of funny. It sounds like me in my 50s.
What's it? Don't
just
set
take
a clock.
Take a lap. Eventually, it'll happen.
Yes, exactly. You know, I know you're not 18 anymore, but give it a minute.
Give it a minute.
Give it a minute.
I still love your doctor. Your doctor is one of my favorites of all time. Eh, not your problem.
Exactly. When I asked him about it, because they say ask your doctor about it, and I'm in there for a totally different thing, and I figured, well, hell, this old guy, I'm going to see what he does. I said, so what do you think about these ED pills? He goes, eh, it's her problem. This guy's got to be in his late 70s.
Having a cigarette while he's talking to you.
Yeah, I had to lean in. I go, oh, really? He goes, yeah. He goes, back in your 20, you can saw wood with these things. You wake up with it. It was with you everywhere. Now, eh, it's her problem. It's the best.
You know what I want to see right now?
What's
that? I think it'd be hilarious. And it might be funny on my side, but because of the way you're set up inside on the studio, when you said that, you kind of look to your, you know, you look over.
Well, yeah, everyone's got to see if the coast is clear.
Because I could see she's there. When you go, that's her problem, did that, you kind of look that way. And if a pillow would have flew through the screen at the same time, that would have been hilarious.
There she is, right there.
Look at her look. She's giving you the, like.
Going solo.
Uh-oh. Mouse is touchy again. She's see, like, her. Right then, when you looked, if a pillow flew by, it'd be hilarious if she yelled you with one.
Let's talk about the doctor. My old doctor talk about ED. It's like, that's her problem.
Why you got to talk to Ed? What's Ed got to do with it?
Why's he got to talk to Ed about it? Yeah, it's her problem. It's like, oh my God. You got a prescription for that, sir? Because I'm about to get my ass kicked.
Uh-oh.
Doctor.
Doctor.
So, yeah, I like my old doctor.
Doctors don't need it. Don't need those guys.
Best part is, and he's got the Vietnam Life magazine covers all hanging on the wall.
Does he?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's that old.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And you sure he wasn't smoking?
No, but I'm sure he used to smoke. He had to have used to smoke. Yeah.
One of those doctors that comes in. Sits down, fires up a freaking.
He probably looks like that. I'll tell you who he looks like. I had to look this up. I know exactly who he looks like. I got this here. But yeah, if he asked me to go have our consultation outside and ask me for a light, that would be the best.
He goes to, like, he does the thing on you where he listens, and you could, when he puts the stethoscope on you, you could smell the cigarette on his finger.
Exactly.
That guy.
Yes. All right, I gotta get this picture up. This is the fucking guy right here. I got him. Right. I got him. Here we go. Let's save this image because this is perfect.
I'm going to tell you what I picture him like, and then I'm going to see if it's close.
All right, picture it. What do you got?
Well, no, go ahead and show me. I want to tell you if it's close or not.
Okay. Let's see. Here we go. Boom, boom. Couple clicks, couple boom, booms. Here we go.
And I'll show you what I picture him as.
Okay. Here we go.
Oh, no, that's not what I've been
doctor from Cannonball Run, dude.
That's freaking hilarious.
That's a good representation of my doctor right there. Want me to stick her with a needle, AJ?
And you like that guy?
Yeah, I've grown to love him even after he poisoned me with the antibiotics. But he's one of them doctors who would tell you, he'll do what you want him to do. The doctor don't feel good. I think he's one of them guys. He would be the doctor in all those commercials when it says, ask your doctor about this. Is the motherfucker to go. This is the guy's going to go. So you think so, huh? And then there you go. I needed time off work for like being sick, he says, how much time you need? Oh shit. 3-4 weeks, whatever works. So you gotta weigh the good and the bad. Almost killed me with the antibiotics. Wrecked me for about 3 months. Days off from work. Got to equal it out.
Now you remember, what was his name? It was Dr. Brackett from Emergency.
Oh, that good looking dude.
No, I'm not talking about him.
Oh, okay. You're talking about the other one.
I'm talking about Dr. Early.
Yes. I know you're talking about. Yes.
That's who wow. And I'm trying to find his picture and it comes up as a Twitter. That's funny. whatever. So this is how I picture your doctor.
Did you find him?
Yeah, I found him.
All right, let's have it.
Oops, I've got to go over here. Share my screen on this side. There we go. And we'll go like this so it's bigger. Oh, don't you wish it was just that easy?
Don't you wish?
Bigger by clicking.
Oh, there you are.
There he is. That's how I picture your doctor right there.
Is that your full screen?
Yeah. There he is.
No, it's a little younger for my doctor.
Hmm.
Yeah, mine basically is. That's the dude right there.
Hmm. Yeah.
Right there.
Yeah, I didn't picture the other one, that's for sure. Because here's the other one. Here they are together. Oh, here he is now. So maybe it's maybe, damn it, that screen isn't.
The transition right there.
Up with my fingers, but that one's not. So maybe it's this guy. Nah, I can't do it that way. Damn it. There it is.
Oh, there you go.
Maybe it's how he looks now.
It's probably a good meld between the two.
Yeah. So there he is. Maybe. That's how I pictured him. But you know what? I think yours nailed him. Obviously, it did because you're the guy who has to go to him. You're the one that's going.
Ariana's
still going on here.
Ariana's on her way to work and to Carson. She goes, anything you want me to bring you back from Carson? Oh, postcard. Picture of a refinery. Is that the area? Drop into Cal Worthington. Bye, babies.
I'm trying to think what else you might be able to get.
It's Cal Worthington and his dog Spot. Here we go. Yeah, that's my doc right there. This guy right here.
There he is.
That's him. That's the son of a bitch right there. Now you got to picture that face. Talking about ED. Oh, that's her problem. And just lean back a lot. I just smile, lean back on, dude. This is you're the best.
Yeah, I get it.
If I had the wherewithal to had, if I had any clue, you know, I would have hit record.
When you go see him, I know we can't record the visit,
right?
But you need to turn on your iPhone in your pocket or something, uh-huh. So we can just hear him.
Just hear.
Yeah, that'd be good.
He's always like I mean, I'm not young, but I'm younger than him. You know, how you doing, sport? How you feeling? All right, take care of this guy. It's like, how you doing, sport? It's like your uncle when you're little. How you doing there, sport? Give me a little shake on the head, a little head rub. How you doing there, buddy boy? How you doing there, sport?
Well, I'm trying. I remember mine. Who was my pediatric doc? Oh, it was Dr. Curtis. I remember.
Yeah.
Like everybody in Upland had him.
Like and lollipops, remember, that kind of good doctor? Lollipops, that kind of thing?
No, he was just a really good doctor.
Okay.
And then I remember going to his office, and as a kid,
mm-hmm.
I would be sitting in the room, and then you would hear him coming with the dress shoes.
Yeah.
Coming down the hall with the, you know, how dress shoes make that clunk.
Yeah, yeah. The distinctive sound.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. He's coming, and you're like, you hear a door, you hear it knock knock. It wasn't your door. And then he goes, it's like, oh, it wasn't me. Then you hear that door close, you're like, clonk, clonk. Oh, and then you hear him, all of a sudden you hear someone pull the papers off of the little rack on the outside.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're like, oh my God.
It's happening.
Oh, here he comes. And then knock knock, door opens. Now I know they knock to let you know they're coming in.
Yeah.
But they don't give you enough time if you had your junk out to put it away.
No, this is basically it's knock knock and then it's already happened. Hello, right. Hello, you good? There's Roy standing there with his dork in his hand.
I used to get blood poisoning in my feet all the time.
I'd
walk around like with no shoes on all the way through the summer, and I'd get something stuck in my foot.
Oh, that kind of thing.
And you're gotcha. Like, okay, it'll get better. And then a few days later, you got this red line going up your leg.
Oh, I see. Right.
And you're like, geez. So as a kid, I go in there one time. At one time, I had a big callus on the bottom one of them.
Mm-hmm.
He goes, well, you know, you want to get it fixed out. I remember having a hat on, and my mom was in there with me. I was probably about 10, I'm thinking. So he's got to cut the callus off and then dig the thing out.
Ooh.
And give me some medicine. And he started cutting on it.
Yeah.
Freaking hurt. And I took my hat off my head and I beat his ass with
it. Did you ever touch me like that, sir? Yeah. Sir.
My hat right off. God.
Backhand your dentist. You big bully.
What a dick kid. But here, he probably could have shot it with something to numb it up a little bit.
Right.
I probably didn't. He's going, oh, we'll just hack this thing off of here.
Damn.
What he gets.
And what'd your mom do? Just lean back.
Lean
back with a smoke. Lean back with a smoke and say, oh, kids. These kids today.
Yeah.
It's best you let Roy finish.
A little angry. Look, there she is. True story.
There's your mom. True story.
Yep.
Walking you out to the car having a cigarette. Good right hook there, Roy. Good job, buddy.
And I remember I got older and I, because he was a pediatric doctor, you know, pediatric doctor.
Right.
And I remember going to him when I was like 17 or 18. I just kept going to him.
Sure. That's your guy.
Right.
Right.
And I remember going to the point where I could go by myself, obviously.
Right.
You know, when you start driving to your pediatric doctor, it's probably time to stop.
It might be a sign.
Right. And I remember sitting in the waiting room a couple of times and it's like, I'm looking around and I look like a parent, you know, I'd have that talk, you know, Roy,
you know, that deep V on your shirt with the hair and the necklace.
Yeah. You know, Roy, I think it's time we need to find you another doctor.
Little Roy Brewster right here.
When you're coming in for prostate exams, your pediatric doctor.
When your pediatric doctor is handing you condoms.
Yeah, when you're asking him about the ED issues, it's probably time to, you know, move on.
Oh, my God. Hey, Doc, it hurts when I pee. Sit down, Roy.
Sit down, Roy.
Or we're going to have to tell you a little something. We need to talk.
Oh, my God.
My pediatric doctor gave me my ED medicine. Keep it in the family all the way through.
Oh, my goodness.
Hey, Steve. Steve Sirianni is checking in with you. Yeah, no Donnie yet. Just let you know.
Just let you know, Steve. She's not
just
here.
Let you know. Oh, no.
And Steve, I don't know if you got here in time, but it's Lisa's birthday.
Lisa Sloan's birthday, Steve.
Lisa Sloan's birthday today.
Yes. Mom, what's the weather out there in Texas? Give me a little update. How y'all doing out there in the Texas there?
Texas area. What are we going to be at today, Jimmy? Seems a little cool outside today.
Well, Roy, I'm glad you asked that. I have that right here. It is a little cooler today. More hazy in Rancho Cucamonga.
Hazy.
Currently 50 degrees, and our high is only reaching 60.
Oh.
60 in the Rancho of the Cucamongas, if you can't tell behind me and also the Roy. It's a little hazy crazy out there. Tony Valdez, the storm. 54 and cloudy, and take your chances, OC. Good morning, Tony. And here's Mom with the weather report. Thank you. Thank you, Dallas Rains.
More at 11.
Exactly. Actually reminds me of the weatherman on Family Guy. Hey, Ollie, what it is? What's the weather like? It's cold. Back to you.
See there?
See now.
Comedic genius, my mother.
Now, Steve would know. Here's a clue when you know that Donna's in the room. Tony, Drew, and Art. Bam, bam, bam. Art eyes, good morning, Don. I mean, it just starts filling up there. Art, Spring, Texas, 64 degrees and foggy. Spring, Texas. How far is that
spring away? Spring, Texas is the place to be.
I think we already asked him which metropolitan Texas he's around. Is he a Houston?
I think we looked it up, too.
Is he a Houston? Is he a Dallas? Is he a San Antonio?
Spring, Texas is... Actually, you know what's funny? Spring, Texas is not too far away from, I mean, it's north of Houston.
Right.
So is my mother.
See, there was my curiosity right there. I was wondering where the vicinity of our listeners would be.
So Spring, Texas is just off the 45 area.
Right.
And mom's right off, it looks like, the 69.
They're right? What? Your mom's off 69?
Yeah, but they're actually time. Very close.
About time.
Yeah, directions from Spring, Texas. I know mom's 69. I just realized that. Spring, Texas to
remember, dude.
Humble, Texas. Because wait, you're not in.
Yeah, there's Art. There's Art right
what
there.
Are you at, Mom? Now you're in Porter, right?
You say Kingwood is only minutes from me. So
wait, I think she's in Porter now, though.
Well, for. The sake of...
I mean, it's about the same.
They'll never meet.
It's they're about 15 miles apart.
Yeah, minutes.
Yeah.
Minutes away. I'm 10, 15 from my mom. So. Yeah,
15, about 15 miles. Mm-hmm. So you guys can meet over there at the... at the Buggies, maybe, and have a coffee.
There you go.
You know.
Hi, I'm Art. Porter is above Kingwood.
Oh, so you are in Kingwood still. I thought one of your addresses said something else. I can't remember.
Here we go.
So they're right there at Kingwood.
Nice.
Look at now they're having a fight already.
But it's cold there, Art, so get a jacket.
So they're probably...
Art, we can do that. That'd be hilarious.
All right, so now here's the problem. See, Kingwood is like 23 miles.
23 miles away from what? What is Kingwood? From Spring. Spring, gotcha. 23.
Yeah. So, because I remember they used to be like right around Humble too. So, yeah, Kingwood's right over there. So, it would be a lot faster if it was the way the crow flies, because you got to go way around the 99 to the 69 and then get into Kingwood. But if you could go just straight through Spring Creek Greenway area, you know, it's probably 10 minutes.
Well, your mom wraps it up right here. Look at that. It's Kingwood with a Porter zip.
You know what? It sounds like you just don't want to be told you live in Porter.
It's like us not saying, what, Ontario? We live in LA.
Yeah, I'm in North Ontario.
Yeah, we live in LA. It's LA. Let's just say it's LA.
I'm in South Ontario.
Just say it's LA. We live in LA.
I'm in Ontario adjacent. Right.
Spring Creek area.
People here, though, they're like, I don't want to live in Rancho Cucamonga. I live in Altaloma.
Altaloma.
I got news for you. It's Rancho Cucamonga. They're incorporated. Altaloma, Cucamonga, Etiwanda became what? Rancho Cucamonga. So the Cucamongas lost their Cucamongas. The Altalomas lost their Altalomas. The Etiwandas lost their Etiwandas. And you're all Rancho Cucamonga now. See, look, some parts of Porter are like South Fontana. I knew it.
I knew it.
I knew it.
There it is.
And I'm going to tell you right now. So you work in Spring Creek, do you, Art? So I am going to tell you where Angel and Don and my mom live. They all live. Really nice area. And Joshua just bought his own home right around the corner. Brand new home.
Well, didn't
believe that he bought his own freaking house already? Little shit.
He's got a good woman behind him.
That must be it. Hey,
because you know,
I got a good one. I didn't buy a house.
And well, you didn't buy one, but you're sitting in one.
Oh, I get it. I get it.
You see. Well, didn't Angel and Don just get a fairly new house about a year or so ago?
Brand new. Yeah.
7 Christmas trees.
I think that was the first year.
Put a Christmas tree in a freaking bathroom.
Yeah, put it in there.
A little excess there. A little showing off.
A little showing off.
You know what? They didn't make
someone did a video about that too long ago at Christmas.
Think your bitterness? 7 Christmas trees?
I don't want to share the subdivision because we're getting a little personal now.
And he is a friend of my brother's, so.
Yeah.
That's kind of a built-in sketchy thing, Art. Sorry.
Can you imagine knocking on the door? Hey! Give me your address.
I can vouch for Art. He's a good dude.
Okay.
He's a good dude.
I wouldn't even know subdivisions. I just know they live over there.
Isn't that a Rush album?
I know it takes like 24 hours to drive there straight through.
All you got to say is he's a friend of my brother's. You go, all right. No, he seems like a nice guy.
Yeah.
But let's be clear.
Yeah, so does your brother.
Exactly.
You know, diving in a little bit in there. You're like, hey, what's going on there? You know, we kid. We love Paul.
Oh, yeah. One of a kind.
What time is Sean coming in?
It's usually about now. So we'll see if he likes us today.
Because I ran down here late.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's a good time for like
you didn't get
like
your coffee.
Like a break.
All right, I'll hook you up.
Or you can just stay here and talk to people.
Nah, I'm really terrible at that. Remember, I tried to solo these things, and I am just horrible by myself. Even though I've had those days going, God, Rory just sucks. Like I can do this all by myself. This mother and son of a bitch. And, you know, all the stuff that's on the inside. But then I go to do it. And I'm just like, hey, how's it going? One time I needed, I'm glad I had a Blaine backing me up because I was horrible. Oh man.
Remember the one Ari jumped into?
Yeah. Yeah. She needed, she goes, man, you're drowning, dude. And I said, I know. Can you believe this? Can you believe this?
And you know why it took so long? Because that was one of the mornings you were waiting for Donna.
Yeah. Stunner, everybody.
Hold on. Hey, well, I'm going to show you my best surprise face.
Is this thing on? Do you still want to do this? Yeah, we still are doing this. Yes, absolutely.
You know, I know Lisa's not listening anymore, but we should say happy birthday to Lisa.
I'll tell you what. Here you are. There's your Lisa. There's your Lisa break right there.
Oh my God, Lisa, you're gonna miss your. Oh.
All right,
I don't want to leave now. Yeah, I'm gonna though.
We'll take our quick break.
I'm not gonna ruin her birthday for her.
We got Sean Williams coming in. Our birthday game coming out. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning. Stay tunaged. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning. It looks like Roy is still on his coffee break, that little bastard. Look at him. He's living the dream right there. Here we go. There's Roy's desk right there all by himself. Look at him. Living large with his two chairs right there. How do you got two chairs right there? Roy, explain yourself. 8:05, we're waiting for Sean Williams, waiting for Donna Maine, waiting to do our celebrity birthday game. We're waiting for Roy Brewster. I think he was expecting two songs right there. Were you right? Were you right? Where's your son at? Sir? Sir? Ariana's on the road right now. But see, you can try with all you want in that car and just let it rip, honey. Just let it rip. Let it rip. David Lesher, good morning, David. Damn, Roy. Maybe Roy had to go, take that kind of break. Number two, if you know what I mean. He is on that new diet. So, 8:06 now. Okay, where'd he go? Oh, I hear him. I hear him coming in. We do have, I'll show you this here. We do have a listener picture right here.
Oh.
It is, we'll stop this right here. Our buddy, our pal. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Art Emery.
What's up, Art?
There's Art. Look at this. Okay, Mom, look at that. He's a decent looking dude. Look at that. You bring his dog over. You guys have some coffee.
It was a decent dog, a decent guy, but it's just not his dog. He's probably stealing it.
Look at that happy dog. You judge a lot by a dude by the happy dog. So everybody, Art Emery right there. Look at that, Mom. Decent dude. I figured you were expecting two songs, right?
I kind of was.
I kind of was.
I was over there and I was in the kitchen and I went, uh-oh.
You know, it's a little quiet right now.
Yeah.
There's Jimmy. Oh, shit. That was me. I did okay.
Well, I had to take my vitamins, my medication.
Good boy. Shit. Yeah, that's his canine. That's a good looking dog, Art.
I usually have my breakfast.
Yes.
And I didn't have any yet.
Oh, I see. I see. Start, now, are you a...
Start eating early.
Are you a first thing in the morning breakfast guy?
With the deal I'm doing, yeah. Within like the first... Should be within the first hour or so waking up, so...
Oh, I see. But okay, before all this. Regular Roy. Are you, you know, you wake up, is like one of the first thought is, you know, oh man, I'm going to have me some breakfast, get my day going, that kind of thing.
No, I like breakfast.
Yeah.
Breakfast is like, hell yeah. But sometimes I would, sometimes I wouldn't. Maybe I'd grab a Velveeta on the way out the door and a coffee or, nothing big, but I try to eat something.
I see. Yeah, I'm not a breakfast guy.
No.
I mean, I love breakfast. We had it for dinner last night, mm-hmm. But I'm just not a guy who eats in the morning. It's just not. When I would go to work, my first meal would be lunch.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Shit ton of coffee though.
Or if you're, you know, oh shit, I forgot my coffee in there.
Get going.
I just realized.
Let's time you. Now we know.
I got. Okay.
Me, your mom, and Ariana know, and Dawn.
Ready?
And go. Dun 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 dun. Roy's on his way. Here we go. Dun 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 dun. I got you on the timer. Here we go. Roy Brewster countdown from the kitchen. Here we go. He's rolling. He's rolling. You're gonna have to add about 2 seconds to this thing. Here he goes. It's a good run. It's all down. It's all single level. There's a couple steps. Be careful. Around the corner. It's coming in. It's coming in. Here we go. Oh boy. Yeah. I'm afraid he's gonna fall down. Coming on 33 seconds. And not bad, buddy. Not bad. We're gonna catch you. We're clocking in at about 36 seconds.
Well, it would have been a little faster, but I had to put a shot of something in my coffee. But I didn't put almond milk in it like normal because I knew I was on the clock.
Oh, I see. There you go. See, your mom knows the house. Tripped on the step. Exactly. Can you hear him moaning? Your camera be on? Dawn. Yes, she did. Remember she ran in the airport jacket?
What?
Remember the airport where she forgot her jacket? Came back on. You guys were on the air?
Oh, yeah.
Ran from the truck. Yeah, I think she kicked your ass on that one. had that little Don run going on.
And on the way back, too, I had a little issue. I had to keep my pants up. They're falling down.
You came back with your shit hanging out. I would have been a hilarious. Banned for life, but it would have been the best last show ever.
Yeah, I'd have done it for ratings.
Of course.
Shit, I'll do it right now.
Sean takes his shirt off for ratings. Your pants could fall down for ratings.
Right. Ah, I felt better now. That's what
happened. Oh, look at this good-looking dude right here. Ladies and gentlemen, Sean Williams.
What is going on? Did somebody say I need to take my shirt off?
No.
Oh, okay. All right.
I was going to say how good you were looking right now. You look sharp right now.
Oh, my God. Look at that mean mugging son bitch.
Thank you. My goodness. How are you guys doing today?
Good, buddy. Look at you sharp-looking son bitch.
Oh, shit.
Thank you.
Roy forgot his coffee.
What's up with that? You got a lot of sparkle on that jacket.
Oh.
That is nice. Look at that. Look at this guy.
It does look like it's sparkling, doesn't it?
No, you know what? That's just you.
Tony Valdez. He gave you the Donna heart eyes. Nice.
Oh, thank you, Tony. It's my. It's because I got this stripper glitter all over me, man, right now. I don't know why.
There's our boy, Art. Welcoming Short Rib in.
Hey, what's up, Art?
Dude, you're looking. What is up with you today? You look like really good today.
Look at him, he's all beaming.
I mean, I'm not to say you look good on the other day, but you're looking like on point today.
Wow. Well, thank you, Roy.
Yeah, you're a good-looking son, bitch.
You know how to. Hey, good morning, Drew. You know how to make a brother feel good. Thank you.
And you just missed this. You know, our buddy Art Emery, Spring, Texas, sent us a picture. There's our boy Art right there with his pup, his little canine. Nice. So
is that a shepherd?
Looks like a shepherd's head. It's part of his canine. He's a canine unit guy.
Oh, wow. That dog will rip you apart right there.
Look at that dog, right?
Yeah, that dog looks nice, but man, when it's time to go to work, that dog will go to work.
Tony says that glitter is fire, bro.
Oh, I forgot that right there.
Look at that. Boy, you are the man. Look at this. Look at this shit coming in.
Internet.
Wow.
Look at that.
Ari, is she still away or is she back?
She's been back. We quarantined her and took her tests and she came back negative.
Awesome. And she still let you broadcast from inside the house?
Well, here's the deal. Here's the deal. We had a situation on Sunday where suddenly we had no hot water. And it turns out the old water heater took a shit and they're putting a new one in. And that's where the studio is. So I had to relocate to the comforts of the home. So Ariana tested.
That's right, because I did before I went to get a look at the. She don't show me the cookie anymore. I think she's mad at me. So before I went to, we'll just say I'm going to dialysis because the cookie has not been shown to me in over 2 weeks. So
oh my God! Come on.
You know what? I think she had a fat fetish because the lower my weight comes down, the less she saw the cookie.
Oh, really?
If I put back on 50 pounds, I guarantee she'll show me the cookie again.
Gotcha. So
she's a chubby chaser. Okay.
I hear you. I wasn't going to say it. Look at the Mrs. Brewster's on you. Look at that shit.
Oh, well, man, thank you, Don. God,
damn, wow. Look at this shit.
This, man, you guys need to stop with the compliments. I'm going to take my shirt off. Here,
it's really, going to happen. Like, it's
I'm
gonna,
feeling it right now.
It's got to happen.
You got me charged. charged up right now.
We did talk about my doctor and his ED diagnosis. So you're right in there with us.
I heard yesterday, I listened to the show.
Yeah.
And you did talk about your water heater. And right before I had to click out, to leave, Roy had talked about going to when he forgot to pay the water bill and he had to go get the sparkless bottles. And I was laughing because we had to do that before. I did that exact same situation where, yeah, I messed up and they locked up my little water thing. And it's tempting. It is tempting to go out there and cut that little thing off and turn that water back on, you know, when you don't have any water.
Right.
And we did have to use the sparkless bottles. It was either that or go jump in the pool and wash up in the pool, you know. So I've had to do that situation before. Hey, Blaine.
Blaine keeping it real. Blaine keeping you humble right there.
He's tamping down my. Right. All right, I got you.
Ariana, Jeff, who? We got a stay of execution for you, buddy. Robin is a proud woman. We're very happy for Robin right now.
She's in there watching on the TV right now. She's in there.
Yeah, a girl.
Robin right now is probably telling one, "Oh God, everyone, please stop."
Robin's thinking
the rest of the day.
Robin's going, you know, you guys have been married a long time. She's going, he just put on a freaking jacket, you guys. It's just the jacket. This old ass jacket I bought him. He won't wear. Now he's the shit. Gotcha.
Good job, brother, man.
He's just beaming, Sean.
You guys are... not only looking good and whatever. I mean, you got that. Like your face is bright and your eyes are on fire. You're, dude. I'm telling you right now, you're a freaking prize now,
give,
Robin.
Let's give everyone a treat. Oh. There we go. Let's go full Sean right here. Look
Robin,
at that.
Right.
Yeah. Look at that, man.
Don't you even think you ain't got it going on with that guy right there?
See that? You hear that? Huh? She knows.
Shit's happening, baby.
She knows.
Mr. Sparkle. Oh, man. So what have you been up to, Sean? What's new, buddy?
Nothing at all.
I don't
know. We're almost done here with this remodel.
I was just gonna ask you, how's that going on?
Done. I mean, the kitchen is done. The floors are in.
I saw the floors.
The only thing left is the bathroom. So, let me tell you a quick story. I told my wife, my wife's like, we got to get the tiles for the bathroom out of the car and get them over so they can start working on the bathroom. And we bought this cart from Harbor Freight, bought this cart, cheap little cart, right? But it's, you know, just wheeling stuff from the car in. It's a lot. It helps out a lot. And it's just aluminum. And I told her, hey, that cart is not going to hold these tiles. She said, yes, it will. Yes, it will. So she goes out there, right? And we're moving the tiles onto the cart. She said, this thing ain't going to hold. Oh, it will. It will. Man, that thing buckled in our driveway, dude. You know how many tiles are to carry from the driveway in? And only because she wouldn't listen, I told her. I said, look. And I didn't even do a told you so. Y'all would have been proud of me. I didn't say I told you so. She said, it broke. I said, really?
Oh, it broke. Look at
it. Yeah, it broke.
Who knew? Who knew, baby? Are you okay? Did you get hurt?
I said, no, you're carrying these hairy, heavy-ass tiles. Yeah, she did most of the work, but if she listened to me, we'd have put 3 or 4 tiles on there, box cases of tiles, and wheeled it in, and then gone back and get the other one, because they're extremely freaking heavy.
Gotcha.
These things are heavy as hell. But, you know, sometimes people don't listen to me. I don't know. Maybe it's because, you know, I'm so good looking that, you know, they think I'm all outside. I don't have a brain. You know, didn't they know what to say?
Yeah, you're just candy.
You're just a shell. You know, they don't respect your brain.
You're just candy, Sean.
All beauty, no brains.
But now here,
Valentine's coming up, right? She just think, oh, he's just chocolate. He ain't got no brain.
He's all chocolate.
And see, I do. I got a little bit up here. I know what I'm talking about.
Come on, entrepreneur. You know. Please,
yeah, right, and then I'm doing it 2 weeks from now. I've already decided I'm cutting that van apart out my backyard.
Oh.
I'm cutting it apart. I'm getting the stuff together, and I'm gonna buy a DeWalt thing and the metal cutter.
Yeah.
And I'm going out there, man, with some goggles on. I'm gonna cut that thing apart.
You're doing it yourself.
I'm gonna do it myself.
Oh, Jesus, Robin, please. Please do some sort of visual. We need this.
I'm doing it because you know what? I was thinking, what would Roy and them do? You know? And I said they would cut it apart. You know, especially with him out there chopping wood and stuff. I can't be down like that. I gotta go out there and show what I'm made of. So I'm gonna cut that van apart.
I have a request for Robin. Just at one point, take your shirt off in full on. Cut mode, and I can have you. That'd be the calendar.
I don't know, dude. Do you know how much my skin will be shaking if I'm not there cutting this thing? Like it'll be like it looked like it was the ocean just ripples just forever. I will not do it with my shirt off. No, I'm putting a tank top on. That's as close as you're gonna get. That's but I'm not gonna take my shirt off because it would be man. You get seasick looking at me shaking out there like that.
You're gonna say, "Am I moving or is he?"
isn't that the love bus or the love dungeon or something?
The love dungeon. That's the one. Love
dungeon. Wow.
Damn, Donna.
It's not Silence of the Lambs in there, Donna. The love dungeon.
Good morning, Art. Good morning, Tony.
Everybody's in the house.
Where's Drew?
Sean and Donna, it is our loyal listener, Lisa Sloan's birthday today.
Good morning.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Lisa.
Yeah, she's not listening anymore. Roy kind of creeped her out.
I was like so nice to her and she left anyway.
That's exactly why. Now, Donna could attest to this. Donna, he was so nice to her that said, "Oh shit. Something's up."
It's very suspicious.
It's very really suspicious. Yeah. So we have a full house here on our Tuesday.
Thanks, Drew. Good morning, Drew.
Tuesday with everybody. So, you know, Roy mentioned we forgot to do our bar bets for Super Bowl this year, Donna.
Damn it.
Oh, yeah.
I was watching the Super Bowl and I went, shit. We forgot to do our annual bar
bets. That would have been interesting. Yeah. Yeah. Since I know so much about football, no, it's always fun to do that stuff.
That kind of stuff.
And I didn't see the whole thing, but I did make sure that I saw the halftime show.
Come on, man.
It was.
I don't. I'm sorry. I wasn't a fan of the halftime show.
No.
And those songs, I like this. I mean, I've heard those songs, those songs are nice. But I just was not a fan of the halftime show.
Yeah.
They could have replayed the Prince one for all I care. I'd have been fine.
Oh, yeah. The Prince one would have been awesome. The thing is with his music and a lot of the music now, I'm trying not to be that guy, you know, going, ugh, kids today. It's just, there's a tone in the music. There's this tone in the music. It's just very, you know what I mean? There's no snap, no uppity. It's just very, you know, I don't know how to describe it. There's nothing upbeat. No toe tapping, except for the.
I like some of his music. I do, and now they said he put $7 million of his own money into that halftime show.
Oh, and he made it back. He made it back, no problem.
Oh yeah, this is putting him more on the map, of course. But I liked the choir. I liked some of the string instruments, you know, some behind one or two of the songs. It was really nice, but I was still waiting for that big bang, you know, like he had dancers but there wasn't much choreography. I'm like, where's the dancing?
There was nothing to dance to.
It was like it didn't come across as 7 million plus, you know. But I don't think it was horrible. A lot of people,
it was just boring.
People were saying there was a little bit of Michael Jackson in there, a little bit of Bruno Mars. You know what? I looked him up. He's actually of Ethiopian descent, but he was born and raised in Canada.
So he's hungry?
Yeah, I mean, he's interesting.
What does that have to do with anything, though? I don't care where he's born. Here's the deal. There wasn't enough dancing because no one could dance and breathe through a jock strap, number one.
True. Number two, story.
This is exactly what I told Don. I said, you know what? I'm not a fan. This is not good. We got a couple songs that we know of his that are good. And here was my exact quote.
Let's have it.
He is very talented. Mm-hmm. To sing like that live is tough. I think he did a great job. His vocals were really good. But this is not a Super Bowl halftime show.
Okay, I'm with you.
I think you're right perfectly. And then, too, in the beginning, there was something off with the sound.
Yeah.
The sound was not right in the beginning because I kept telling Robin, is something wrong? Like, it's not really coming through.
Yeah, you couldn't hear him as much as you could hear the music. Yeah.
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 What he did do was he employed he employed a lot of people. He had so many people on that field, but then there was no thank you. There was no real choreography. There was just so many people.
Yeah, they're right there. I think Ariana nailed it right there.
He's a good singer. Yeah,
not an energy, just like Roy said. Exactly.
And this is the first Super Bowl that I can remember in a while that there wasn't a special guest
on
the halftime show.
Right.
You know, like last year it was Shakira and
J-Lo.
And Jennifer, and then somebody else came on too.
Right.
The year before that, they always have like another Bruno Mars, a couple other people.
I missed
on. This guy did the whole thing by himself, and he's not a band. It's just him.
Right.
You know?
Although, there's other people that have done it themselves. And actually, I mean, I think Lady Gaga did it herself. And it was the production. I think the production was lacking. You know what I mean? Like
nobody was with him because he was from Ethiopia. No one wants to do that with anyone who was born in Ethiopia.
They don't want to get they don't want to get that Ethiopian stank on them. I think Ariana mentioned she missed Janet Jackson's titty while we're watching this one. Yeah. Sean, he just gives a nod. Just
said, we are the world, you know?
Right.
That's what he should have said. We are the world.
Up with people.
Up with people
from the 70s or 80s.
Oh, see, wholesome fun.
I didn't see the beginning. I guess Miley Cyrus and some people performed before the game. And I thought maybe Miley and some other people were going to join him for the halftime show, but that didn't happen.
Well, a lot of people before were like this girl, H.E.R., her. She was great. She sounded awesome. I forgot what she sang, America the Beautiful or some shit like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, she had a great voice, and a lot of people before the show sounded pretty good, but there you go.
Yeah.
There you go. So you guys ready for our Tuesday tradition?
Hey.
Do they say it's your birthday, you guys?
Roy is going to make a vicious comeback this day.
Now you didn't only beat me last week. You embarrassed me.
Annihilated him. You got annihilated.
So, I think I lost by like 3 points, Mr. Williams.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. It was brutal.
So I'm getting the scorecard ready here.
Okay.
Sean and Roy. There we go.
There we go. Sean and Roy. Let me get us all set right here.
Very good.
You're all set there,
Roy. Hey, Jimmy, did you see Linda was selling that thing? I just thought of what we could use it for. I could put it up behind me and program the score into it every time.
I was going to say something. Our friend Linda, she's selling one of those message boards. It's probably about 2 feet long, but you know, you can scroll your message across.
Oh, the digital readout?
Yeah. It's the old school one, like with the rainbow colors and shit. And no purpose in life at all. But she posted it and realized, like, I wanted it. And I'm like, God, I want that. I don't know why. And then Roy actually typed it. And I'm like, me too. Let's go get it. Road trip.
Like, I want it. And it's like 300. It's an expensive one, like $300 or $500 or something. And she says, just $50. Someone take it. And it's like, I want it. I have no idea.
Where is she? I want to take it.
Was she like Lancaster?
Right.
It's one of those things you hang it up and just say, you know, good morning. Breakfast is ready or some stupid shit you want to put on there. But the birthday game and
her behind.
Yes.
Like when you're on video, you know, or whatever. That's awesome.
Right.
That could be very cool.
Oh, man. I just looked down and the light hit Donna's glasses. She was just all lit up like a robot. I was like, holy shit, what happened to Donna? Looked like a Stepford wife. All right, guys. So birthday game, you guys already. Roy, Sean, Donna.
All right.
Are we good to go here?
Actress Mary Steenburgen.
Mary Steenburgen,
everyone. I have no idea who this is.
Mary Steenburgen.
You know what? She's in so many movies and TV shows. It's crazy. And she's married to Ted Danson for several years now. And
she was, Sean, have you seen Back to the Future?
Yes.
She was in Back to the Future 3, Doc Brown's wife in the Old West.
Oh, I can't get through that one.
All right. Well, here we go. So, Sean, can I assume you're going to defer?
I am going to defer.
All right.
All right. So, Mary, we're going to need to, we're going to hang something on Mary because she's,
oh,
she's
I bet you want to.
My wife says she's in Father of the Bride also.
Oh, there you go. Yes.
Is she?
I think she's in a TV series right now. Because I saw her recently, and it was like all of a sudden she looked older.
Right.
Like she's actually letting herself age a little. She's not doing the.
No, she did. She did. She looks kind of terrible now.
Okay, we're gonna hang a 12 to 14 on Mary. Maybe a little less. So it's 55, and I'm gonna be 56. So it's getting that thing where you gotta be careful.
Be very,
so
very careful.
I'm gonna hang a 50. We're gonna hang a 12 on Mary, and let's make her 12 on Mary before my birthday. So let's go 50. 60. I almost said 50. 60. I'm thinking 66. Maybe only 11. Go 67.
Roy with 67. Sean Williams.
Okay. She's married to Ted Danson, right?
Yes.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Ted Danson has got to be pushing. He's got to be pushing 70.
Ooh.
And I'm going to assume that Ted Danson's wife would probably, he's a type that's probably going to have somebody that's at least 5 years younger than him. So I'm going to say on that part, what did Roy say?
67.
67.
I'm going to say she's 65.
All righty. So Roy with 67, Sean with 65. The answer is
68.
Ah, no.
Turning 68 this week. Yeah.
I thought you were, I'm thinking she might have been a little older. When you said you thought she was older, I thought you were going to go one more and lock me out. Oh, I got lucky.
As soon as he said 10 dance and 70, Sean, or Roy was like, oh, I messed up. That was the key right there. All right, next up, Nick Nolte. Sorry, Donna, this one's yours. I'll be quiet. Here we go.
Nick Nolte, the actor.
There you go. Good job.
I haven't seen him for a while. Have you seen him do anything lately?
He's in like a few independent movies I'll catch on Netflix. He's done over the last few years. He's still a great actor.
He's a tough one because he's always looked a little ragged, so a little rough around the edges.
I'm gonna go ahead and go with this one.
What's his best movie line, Sean? We ain't brothers, we ain't partners, we ain't friends.
Yeah, that's the only movie that he's did that I actually like.
Yeah, 48 Hours.
Yes.
Let's go 70. Let's go 70s. Oh, God.
No good.
See it. Let's go 78.
Okay.
I don't think he's almost 80 years old yet. I think he's a little younger. Because I'm going to say when 48 Hours came out, I was in my teens and he had to be at least 25 years older than me. So, well, damn, that would make Roy kind of right. I'm going to say 77.
Oh, all right. So bastard. What did Roy say, Donna?
You said 78, Roy?
Yeah.
Yeah. And Sean said 77. The correct answer is
how about 80.
No? He's turning 80.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Wow. I thought Sean got that one for sure.
Damn.
I thought I overshot it by a couple.
The big 8-0. Yes. Well,
what's our score after two, Roy?
He's two up. He's two nothing.
Oh,
two
nothing. Shit. Here we go. Next one up. You love him. Here you go, Donna.
Okay. Next up, actor Joe Pesci.
Oh, God.
This is another great picture. Good one. Right?
John, go ahead. I
okay.
Look at him with the Under Armour shirt on.
No one's buying that.
Yeah.
That's okay. That's mine and Roy's pick for the new host of Jeopardy, by the way.
Funny how.
Yeah. You gonna bet it all, you stupid son of a bitch?
You laugh? I'm here to amuse you?
Yeah. You bet it all, you stupid son of a bitch. You lost.
Okay.
He's kind of in disguise right. in this
so
picture.
So,
Yeah, you can't tell it's him, right, Donna?
I mean, the hat, the sunglasses.
Okay, Joe Pesci has been around a long time. But he didn't start really getting the first movie that he was in was Home Alone, which was in like 1990, somewhere around there, 1989, somewhere in between there, when Home Alone came out. I took my nephew to see it. And he was, I'm going to say at that point, he would have been in his 30s. And fast forward, I'm going to say Joe Pesci is got to be at least 70. Damn, you guys got all these old people here today. I'm going to say he is it's 77.
Ooh.
All right.
I like it a lot. Now, a smart play would be to pick 77, so at least we both get a point if we're close. But my deal is right here. I want to bury Mr. Williams.
Hoo-hoo, you.
And man, I think he's right there. But I'm going to go... I'm going to go 76.
Final answer?
Yep.
Okay. The answer is 78.
Oh!
What did you say, Sean?
77.
Oh!
So Sean got that one.
Nice. Good job. Good job, Sean.
Score to nothing right now.
Good job, buddy.
My grandma had balls. She'd be my grandpa, too. So.
All right. Next up, our fourth celebrity birthday this week. Actress.
Is Elizabeth Banks. Elizabeth Banks, actress. I don't know if you do you know her very well, guys?
No.
She was in
Yeah, she's been in a couple of things I saw, but I can't place her.
Pitch she was in Pitch Perfect.
Okay.
The one of the announcers. And she's one of them gals that's been in like everything. And you're like, oh, that's her.
Yeah, I'm trying.
She was in the 40-year-old virgin. She was the gal who worked in the store when he made his big move. So, Elizabeth Perkins.
Perkins?
Oh, Elizabeth Banks. Elizabeth Perkins. That's a whole different Elizabeth right there. That's the gal from Big.
Yeah, man, Elizabeth Banks.
Elizabeth Banks.
Roy?
This is a tough one.
Is it passing to me?
Yeah.
I really don't know.
Ooh, these are my favorite ones, when they don't know.
Yeah,
man, I really don't have anything to go on. I'm going on the picture. Is that a current picture?
Yes, that's a current picture, Roy.
Okay. Shit. 45.
Ooh.
And that's like a wag. That's a wild ass guess, dude.
I think she is. Oh man, I think she's older.
Probably is.
I think she's older. So I'm gonna say no.
I'm gonna say no. Shut up. Just gonna... We get so much pleasure out of watching you guys sweat.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna say she's 48.
Alrighty.
Okay, the correct answer, and you said 45, right,
yeah.
Roy?
Yeah.
The correct answer is 47.
Sean Williams.
Sean.
I'll take it.
He's wiping the sweat off. That took a lot out of you guys for not knowing who she is.
You really don't know. I've seen her in a couple of things, but I don't know who she is.
Well, I love those.
She's a tough one. She's had like a lot of smaller roles, and yeah, hard to say how long she's been around.
All right, next
Why
up.
Why she's so pale?
Because she's a white girl.
She's really pale. Yeah.
Midwestern.
Exactly. Probably. Next up, probably. America's sweetheart.
Jennifer Aniston. What?
That's not a good picture of her. She looks better than that. That's not a good picture.
It's Jennifer Aniston. Take
it. I don't know if you guys know this, but Jimmy had a shot with Jennifer.
Yeah, apparently, according to my ex-wife, I could have made it. Could have made it, pal.
Wow.
Sean's heard my Jennifer.
Sean's heard. I'm referring to Roy.
Sean's heard my Jennifer Aniston bit.
I have.
How many more do we have?
This is she is Jennifer number five out of seven.
Seven. Yeah. Okay, so we have
Jennifer and then two more.
Okay. So Jennifer, I believe, and this is just previous birthdays. She's close to us, but a tad younger. So we're gonna have to take some off of Jennifer here, a little clip clippy choppy choppy. and it's probably a 3 to 5. So this is hard because whatever I do, Sean could just lock me out either way. So man, is it her big 5-0 this year? Let's go. I think it might be. Let's go. Let's go 50.
Okay.
Sean, you're looking her up right now, aren't you?
No.
I know you. I'm just kidding.
I know.
I think she's the same age as me. I don't think she's younger than me. I think she's the same age. And I'm going to say that she's 52.
All righty.
Okay. Ooh, the correct answer is 51.
Oh!
Right down the middle.
Right. See, I should have went one over him. I should have hit the smart, the strategic play, because that's what he would have done.
Exactly. That is the game play right there, yes. One up or under.
That would have been tough because it would have been 4-2 with only two left. So now it's 3-3 with two left.
3-3 with two left. Yeah. Here we go. Next one.
I thought maybe she was a little bit older because it seems like she's been right around 50 for a long time now. But 51 is what they say.
Is she still not married?
No, she's not married currently.
That's because she's got the stank on her. Oh, I love this guy.
Comedian, actor, Arsenio Hall.
Arsenio Hall.
That finger up, Jimmy.
Yeah.
The dog pound.
Okay, so who gets to this? I guess, you know, we both won the point, so.
Yeah, but you won the last one.
Okay.
Yeah, Sean Let's gets the you. Call on this one.
Well, I'm going to go ahead and just go. I'm not going to push Roy to go. I'm going to go.
All right. Okay. Do it.
And I think Arsenio Hall is definitely in his 60s, right? And I'm going to say he's at his early 60s. And I'm going to put Arsenio Hall. Oh, man. He's gotta be 60. I'm gonna say that. I'm gonna say Arsenio Hall is 60.
All right.
Okay.
All right. I think you're close. I think he's in his 60s, but just to play it, because I don't think he's right at 60, and I'm pretty sure he's not in his 50s, so I'm gonna go 61.
You know what? I want Arsenio's suit. That's badass.
Yeah, that's a nice suit.
All right, so Sean,
right, in that one, baby. So we have a 60 and a 61, and yep. guess guess what?
How about new?
He is now eligible for Medicare. 65.
Whoa. Wow.
Whoa. Yeah. So what, point to Sean on that one?
No, Roy.
Oh, that's right. Roy, that's right. Roy
says 61, right?
That's right. Oh, damn.
Last question, last birthday. It is now 4, Roy, 3, Sean.
Oh, boy, this is a tight one. Here we go. Last one up.
All right, one more. Michael McDonald.
That's a weird ass picture of him.
Now
the voice of the Doobie Brothers.
Now you know how to do the impression of Michael McDonald, right? Get your two pinkies.
Show us.
Two pinkies. Corner your mouth. He can hook somewhere back in her room. And there you go. Nail it every time.
All right. So I'm going to go ahead and play because Michael kind of falls to me like the younger side of those rockers that I always pick in their 70s. But I think he's like really close to that, but he might be a little younger.
And now you see that I picked this picture because every picture from the 70s, he already looks like he's 70. You know what I mean? So
right.
I figured now I better just go with a current one.
Completely silver fox. Yeah.
Right. We got some guesses in there. We got Lisa Parcell in there. Drew's banging out the guesses.
Yeah.
Man, I'm thinking like 70s, but I would like be so upset if he was 69. I didn't pick it.
Okay.
man, this
I'll be
is
right
tough.
There. I'll be right there, Bob. Okay.
Nah, man, I'm gonna defer.
Oh wow, to Sean.
Son of a you. There's a child in the room, so I won't crush it. Okay.
I'll be right there, Bob.
Because the child's in the room, so I can't cuss at you. All right. Okay. Here's my thought process on this one. Since I'm going first, you got to hear my thought process. Now, my thought process is that the show with Raj and all of them was on in the 70s, right? Like 78, 79.
Which doobie you be?
And then in that episode where they met the Doobie Brothers, where they were trying to get tickets to go see the Doobie Brothers, right?
Which Doobie you be? I love that one.
I was 11 years old, right?
Okay.
So at that point, he had to have been in his 30s at that point, right? So, or late 20s or 30s. So I'm going to say that he was in his 30s. So I'm going to put 21 years on that guy. And if I put that on, right, 31 years,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to say this dude is 81 years old.
Sean with 81.
No. Okay. So, just to play the game, I'm going to say 80 because it's only one under Sean. I just locked him out at every other number under because I think all those rocker guys are low 70s, but I think he's a little younger. So my official answer, you said 81, right?
Yes.
Okay. My official answer is 80.
Wow.
But I'm going to say, back of my head, I'm thinking 70.
Okay.
All right. The correct answer is 69.
Oh my God.
How's that make you guys feel? 69.
Isn't 70 years old yet?
No.
How the hell can that be?
And Roy was, he said 69. He did say it.
Yep.
He did say it. He said he would be upset if it was not 69. Yes. What's the score, Roy? Is that it?
But you got
5-3.
5-3. Yikes. Oh my God.
Oh, wow.
You guys want to do a quick speed one here? I always pick one for a tiebreaker, so I'm not going to give you time.
You don't need it.
Yeah,
you don't need it.
I'm just going to throw this out. You guys, this first number comes to your head. Here we go.
All right, do it.
Whoops. Let me click the picture here. Here we go. Jerry Springer, go.
Oh, my God. Jerry Springer.
Roy Brewster. 79. Roy.
82.
77.
Oh.
There you go.
Oh, I was going to say 77.
Atta girl.
Just a guess.
Look at that.
Guys, I'm going to have to take off because we have painters here today.
Put them on.
So, yeah. And my assistant here is letting me know.
She's got people. She's got little people. Yeah. All right, Donna, we'll talk to you next week then.
All right, guys. So good to see you. Have a great week, everybody. Love Peace. You guys.
See ya.
Bye.
Bye-bye. And gone. Boy, that last one took you guys decades out.
Wow, I was so off on that one.
Wow. You guys were out.
Jesus, I'm picking 80 in this guy. He's not even, he's 69. Well, they've been around a long time, man.
Yeah, in the chat room, I think the closest one we had was Lisa Parcell. She came in at 71. Ariana had 74, so they were in the range. They were in the range there.
Jesus.
No,
that upsets me that he
won. No. Drew nailed it. 69 on the dot.
Drew?
Yep.
Oh, man. Get it.
Yes. You guys went to the 80s. That's why it's going, really? Are you sure?
The Doobie Brothers have been around forever.
Forever.
Though.
Yeah. Like you said, that What's Happening episode, which Doobie you be? Yeah. I love that one.
Gosh. Yeah, man, I got to get a new work up because it's not working for me right now. I need to work up like how I guess these dates because it's just not working right now.
Well, I think we need to find a third wheel because Roy said that was one of the most exciting birthday games last week with Eric and you dominated.
Well, I don't know. Maybe we do need to get somebody a third person guessing in there.
Right.
You know, maybe we should invite a guest, one of your loyal listeners each week. Just pick one randomly to come on and do the birthday game with us.
Yeah.
I'm sure everyone has a camera.
Well, yeah, everyone's got a camera. So anyone who's listening who wants to be on the birthday game, just hit me up and I will send you the link and you can play the birthday game with us.
Tony.
Sean had the matching sparkle pants.
I don't know why my wife is texting me like, why is your jacket sparkling? I have no idea. It's just the green with the light. And I guess the camera, it makes it sparkle.
Dude,
is really freaking weird.
It is.
You know? But I like it. I kind of like that style.
It kind of looks like Star Trek when you're about to be fate, you know, transported out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It does.
So shiny,
beat
Sean.
Me up, Scotty. That's what I'm saying, right?
That's you.
Wow.
Oh my gosh. What do you got going on, Sean? Anything coming up? Any shows or
nothing, man? I think I have a Zoom show in March coming up.
Yeah.
That I'm going to do I think 15 minutes of clean comedy.
Oh, nice.
And you know, we'll get that worked out. What about you guys? Any fun and exciting things coming up?
Please. I'm getting a new water heater in about an hour.
Are you doing it yourself or
no, landlord sending the people out. Yeah, I've just been doing stuff and actually doing a lot with my mom. I put a new garage door in on the, you know, one of them, the side doors. I put a brand new one with the frame in, did some plaster work for her, hung some not shower curtains, new living room curtains. Just helped my mom out, having a good time with her.
You're doing some man shit. Oh,
dude, I put a door in this motherfucker. Steel, pre-hung, frame and everything. And then put some, redid the plaster, painted it out, feathered it in. Shit came out professional. And see level.
That? We tried to make a towel ladder this weekend and it came out fucked up. You know? So that's why I gotta do so. I gotta learn to do some man shit like you. Cause my wife's been watching these YouTube videos and she saw a towel ladder.
Yeah, there she is right there. You seen one of those? Yes, I've seen those.
It's a ladder, right? You were out there on the ground, right?
Yeah.
Trying to screw this thing in, and then you know, we get it all screwed in and we stand the fucker up, man, and one is
stand
down
the fucker
like
up
six. One is down 6 inches higher than the other one. It's all leaning and shit, man. And I'm like, oh, man.
We stand the fucker up.
Yeah, dude. It was, I don't know. She's like, hold it. you know, and she's drilling, and I'm trying to, man, I don't know. See, dude. I told y'all last time we tried to make an island, like a portable island,
right?
And we stood it up, and it fell apart. You know, as soon as we put something on, it fell apart. So,
oh god,
we bought wheels and everything for this fucking thing, dude. We went out and yeah.
Oh my god.
So I got to get better at doing some man shit.
Oh yeah, I've been doing man shit a long time, and she's had this old garage door, and you know, it's all beat up and shit from all the weather and everything, and it's just one of those things. I said, you know, I got time. I go, let's put a door in, and so
what is that?
So we, what's that?
No, keep going, Jimmy.
Oh, I thought Sean said something.
No, I did. I was like, he keeps showing us this picture. I don't know what that is.
Yeah, what is that, Roy?
I was waiting for Jimmy to finish his story first.
Oh, here we go. There's my door right there.
Nice.
Look at that shit.
Look at that.
All painted up.
It's even too. It's level.
Yep.
Wow. See, if I had to put that in, the bottom of it would definitely be 2 inches lower than the other half of it.
Couple of YouTube videos, and I said, oh, hell, let's do this, mine. And my mom's a trooper. She was backing me up on every play. She had my back. She had this going. She had the screw gun ready. She was my best assistant.
See, that's awesome, dude.
All right. So what do you got, Roy? What do you got going on?
Well, I ordered an oil pan like weeks and weeks and weeks ago.
Right.
And it finally has arrived. Here's my oil pump. I'm putting the oil pump, oil pan, timing cover, all the stuff on the boat.
Old boaty boat stuff. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Nice.
You got to put, you're putting that motor back together.
Yeah.
Today?
Last parts of it. Yeah. I ordered that pan. I don't know how long ago. I almost forgot I ordered it.
it's been a while,
and it showed up yesterday.
Yeah, there we go. Robin and R got my back here. Thank you. Yes, sir. See, I'm very ADHD on shit like this. Very anal.
You guys are so awesome, man. Roy, I mean, you put a door in, and Roy is gonna put the boat motor in today. Jesus Christ.
When that thing about putting that door in, right? There's existing plaster, so I couldn't break it up, so I had to kind of custom fit this thing, and then I had to custom apply the plaster so it blended, and then I painted a shadow line so it looked like it belonged there.
Here's the thing, too.
It took some work.
The thing that Jimmy did is it wasn't drywall.
No.
Drywall can be manipulated a lot more because, you know, if you cut it, you just patch it and put another piece in.
Piece of cake. Put some compound on it. Boom, boom, boom.
Plaster. Oh.
Oh, baby. Oh, baby. And I taped blue taped my line so the shit looked nice and clean. Even though it's a garage door on the outside, you won't see any of that shit. But when mom says, Jimmy, put that on, I don't want people looking at it going, huh, well, he put it on. But now you look at it and go, shit, damn, Jimmy. Jimmy.
Man, that is good. That's skill right there. That's skill.
I want to put some new.
I just don't have. I mean, I could have hung the door. You know,
yes.
I could have hung it. Now, don't get me wrong. Now, if somebody kicks our door in, I can put up a door. You know, I can put up a door, but it once we close it, you ain't gonna open it again.
It's not.
You don't want to open it again. It won't close twice. It'll close once.
And I retrofitted her can lights in the kitchen with the LEDs. Replaced about six of those. That shit. Place looking bomb, man. I got that place dialed in.
We had to pay somebody $1,500 to put in a new door in our house.
Oh.
Look at that. See? So Jimmy,
I would have done that for you.
There you go. There you go. Art was asking. There it is.
Oh, yeah. No, you sent me the picture, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, we got to give him a better picture than that.
There it is.
So there we go.
Art was asking 350. Yeah, it's a 5.7. It is 40 over.
Yeah, no, we got it.
Probably about 330-ish horsepower, which isn't too crazy, but we don't want to blow the freaking out drive up.
Right.
So no. I have a question for you, Roy.
Uh-oh.
Okay. All right. So please, it may sound like a stupid question, but I've been wondering about this.
What you got?
Okay. So you fixed a boat in your garage, right?
Oh.
Okay. So how do you test it? So you put there's no water. Can you run it without water?
Yeah. So what you do is you put these little, they're like, they call them ears or whatever, and you put them on the outdrive and you turn the hose on, and then it keeps water running through the outdrive as it goes, and you can fire it up in the driveway and do that stuff. But I mean, for final, we're gonna have to take it over to Silverwood or somewhere and put it in the water and get it all worked out before the summer. So that's why we got to get it done. So we'll have a few of those under our belt, make sure it's all, you know, dialed in before we take a couple long trips.
You going back up to Utah this summer?
Yeah, we'll be at Powell in June.
I told you I did the redid the electrical in my garage, right, Sean?
Oh, yeah. Sean. Oh,
yeah.
Please.
Yeah, put a bench in, ran power where power didn't happen, hit the junction box at the garage door opener, ran my Romex and my conduit down, grounded it down.
Actually, Jimmy, you know what? Here's the problem in my garage.
What you got?
So behind where I have the air compressor.
Yes.
All right. It was a light switch.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to turn it into a light switch outlet.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Now the problem is I can't actually, thanks Art. I can't actually do that because the power coming from the light switch is a powered one from the other side of this other side of the garage, mm-hmm. by the house entrance.
Right.
So the only way I can really do that is to run another hot wire on its own all the way over, correct?
Yeah, we'd probably run a 14-gauge Romex and just put a new box in, a double box. Leave the light switch all by itself. That wiring's all done. But we're just going to add a plug in, so we'll just put a dual box in there, run a new piece of Romex down, probably a 14-2 in your garage. Right. And, run it down there, and just a brand new one, probably tap from the garage door opener or something.
Well, and the garage door opener does have power up there I could pull from.
Right.
But I didn't want to like go into the wall, so I guess I would probably just conduit on top of it.
Quick piece of conduit. Yeah, we can do a nice clean job.
Yeah.
And then we'll go over to Sean's and wire up his VW bus.
Because I was thinking about the bus, Sean.
Put some Christmas lights and shit around.
I got an acetylene torch in the garage.
Uh huh.
I could put that in the back of the truck, pull it out there, and we could torch that thing. Just cut it. Gas cut it just without all the trouble of having to
hand saw it and shit.
Be all tired, just like, and just start hacking.
Thing just
it up.
Slices right through, Sean.
Okay,
all right,
I'm down because I was literally gonna go. I talked to my neighbors next door. The guys, they're always taking apart carts and stuff.
Right.
Like, so I talked to these guys. They're always building Hondas and everything. And he goes, oh, just get a DeWalt. And get that metal thing. You can get that one of those DeWalt.
Mm-hmm.
He goes, you can either rent one or get it from Home Depot. Just buy it. And he goes, you can just cut that thing into like three pieces. Just carry it right out. And I was like, oh, hey.
See Sean trying to carry the front half of a.
I'm just gonna chop it. I think I'll chop it down the back, chop the middle, and then chop the front.
Right.
But first, I'll knock out the glass. Because you can't go through glass with that thing, right? Or you only get all scarred up.
So, yeah,
right.
It won't be a good. Yeah, not a good move.
Wait a minute. Hey, Sean, how bad is the body on that thing?
The body?
Yeah, like the nose of it?
The nose of it is fine. I mean, I was actually thinking about going, taking pictures and selling it piecemeal. Because the door you could use, the nose of it is fine. It's perfect with that big emblem and all that other stuff. Like, yeah.
That might be the way to go. Like you said, piecemeal it out. You got the doors, the windows alone would probably cost a lot of money.
Yeah.
The thing is, you just got to have someone say, here's one of those things. You got to put it up on there and just say, parts for sale. And someone says, how much is a window? All the windows cost this much. You're not going to sell one window at a time. You know what I mean? So put in an ad, windows from a Volkswagen bus, year, blah, blah, blah. All windows, make offer. Come get.
I think we need to look at the parts that are salvageable first.
Yeah.
Because they can bring really good money.
Yeah, especially in those VW buses.
Just unbolt those and make sure that you have all those that you could sell.
For money.
If you want to get rid of the rest, get rid of the rest. But the nose of it, Jimmy, you know where I'm going here?
Dude.
How cool would it be to make the nose of it a cool bar, get it all painted cool?
And we're not talking like $20 and someone talk you down to five. We're talking hundreds of dollars for the glass and the nose. Take a picture of it and send it to me. Give me a front shot this way. And
I will do that.
You got some money sitting back there, buddy.
Okay.
You probably can pull safely, Roy. What do you think? Five, maybe $600 of parts off that thing.
More than that.
Yeah, more than that. I went low.
Yeah.
I will do
it just depends if it's in good shape
this afternoon.
Yeah, yeah.
What year is it?
I believe it is a 69.
Oh, dude. Oh. Yeah, that's money right there.
And it's a Westfalia, is it right?
The camper thing?
I'm not sure.
Oh, yeah, well, the camper, right? Send a picture to us.
Yeah, it has the camper.
Oh, yeah. Dude, the inside parts might even be worth it. We're talking fixtures and shit like that. Oh, my God, dude. You might be on
Like I said, when I put it on it, the guy was hitting me up for the stick shift. You know, if he wasn't such a dick, I'd have took it off for him. But, you know.
He's the one who argued with you.
Take it off, but I'll figure out how to get that stuff off, you know.
Yeah, dude, the parts on that alone. But send a picture, see what we can do for you. Yeah.
I will. I will send it today.
All right. Look at that one. We are after 9 o'clock. Hey, we're going to have to wrap this baby up.
All right, guys. Thank you.
No, thank you, buddy. Donna and Sean and everybody listening and watching. Thanks again. This has been Rory and Jimmy in the Morning right here on Facebook Live. YouTube Live. We're back next week. Monday, Tuesday, 7 to 9 a.m. on the Pacific Times. You guys are awesome. Sean, boom. You're the best, man.
Peace. You guys. Love you guys. Take care.
You too,
have
buddy.
Have a great week, everyone. Stay healthy and safe. See you next week. Hit them, buddy. Look at that.